So, maybe
you're going to end up doing it in the end, but doing it this way is going to cause you more trouble than it's going to cause help. And I don't understand why Casey's can't do whatever they want to on their property.
Well, they're a use that, and I don't know the history of when things changed back at that time. But at this point, Casey's is not in a B1 district, it's an SR2 district. They cannot extend their use in an SR2 district.
I understand that, but when they built that building, it was a B1 district.
Well, that
and it changed right after they built it.
All right, so we have an item on the agenda, and it takes in whether we want to approve the recommendation from the zoning board or not approve it. So obviously we have some folks here who are expressing their dislike for that, and so do we have anyone here on the council this time that wants to make a motion on this item?
I do.
All right.
To make a motion, we approve it.
All right.
Take the recommendation from the board.
Mr. Bratton would like to make a motion to approve. Is there a second for that motion?
I'll second his motion.
All right. We have a motion and a second. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed?
No.
So take a roll call vote, please.
No. Alderman Curry Whitman?
No.
Alderman Brown?
No.
Alderman Voss?
No.
Alderman McComb?
No. I'm going to sustain from it. I don't know enough about it right now to claim it either way.
Alderman Herbert?
No.
Alderman Bratton?
Yes.
Alderman Bastian?
Yes.
Alderman Campos?
No.
All right. 6-4, that motion fails.
I'll make a motion to table.
Second.
All right, we have a motion. It's Mr. McComb, did you have something else you want to say?
Well, I'm just going to try to put this vote off for 2 weeks to sometime next month at the next council meeting. So if we need to notify the citizens in that area, we could do that and give them an opportunity to speak. I mean, I understand we need to go along with what they're recommending, but I think we need to will the citizens living in that area too a chance to voice their opinion. Rather than voting on it tonight, I would like to see it brought up. So I was going to say before Danny made his motion that to give everybody a chance to look at what's going on. And I know we need our businesses in town. It's not going to break Casey's if they don't get wider. But we also need our citizens, and we just need to have a little bit more input from the citizens on this deal. Maybe sit down and explain to them a little bit more about if we have to go house to house in that block on both sides of the street. I mean, how many businesses we got in that block now?
Well, I'm not sure, but I think the
that's why I made the motion to table.
Right. So, but I do want to point this out, and then I'll get to WCA board, and that's it. The process for this zoning change is exactly the same as every other zoning change that we ever go through. There's a zoning board that meets, considers the matter. I know that these letters may not be literature by any stretch of the imagination, but I do just want to make that clear that the process that was went through is the same process that we always go through, and I think it's just important to point that out because we're certainly not trying to be dodgy about the matter.
I'm assuming the letter came. Did it come from the Board of Appeals?
No, it came from City of Murfreesboro Public Works.
Can we send an additional letter
Wait a minute, I gotta say something. I wasn't gonna say anything. The letters
tell them to call if they need to. If there's any questions, we want people to call. That's what it says. We're not trying to hide anything from anybody. I try to stay in the middle. I mean, it's not my opinion to do this. I mean, what's going to happen here?
Excuse me, it also says go to this meeting here tonight.
No.
Yes.
No, that was the Board of Appeals meeting last week.
As far as the notice is concerned, the procedure required is that everyone within the area proposed to be rezoned, and then every landowner who is adjacent to that property, they all individually receive the notice. Then there's a newspaper publication of that hearing. It's the Zoning Board of Appeals.
But that letter is lawyer speak. It doesn't explain that if your house burned down, you couldn't replace it. It doesn't say that. Why not say that? Why not go tell people what would happen to their house if it burned? Why just send a letter that, I'm sorry, but it is lawyer speak. It doesn't explain what any of that means.
Mr. York, I appreciate your feedback. Mm-hmm. We have a motion and a second to table this item. I don't think that we're going to improve upon our discussion
right.
by continuing it at this
okay.
point.
All right.
I just wanted to say that sometimes it's up to us also to find out what's going on, and probably if we take sometimes a little bit of a breath and breathe slowly, that letter probably will find out that you could have gone to that meeting last week. So it both goes both ways.
Oh, I understand.
Really. So we are accountable for what is in front of us and make the decisions. And so the city is.
I want to
let her speak first and then we'll go to the comment.
Yes, so it goes both ways. I understand your concern, sir, and I'm really sorry that this is going on this late, but this already passed. You see what I mean? And I feel bad for all what you're facing, because I am a homeowner, too. We all are. And we can be on your shoes too tomorrow or today or yesterday. That is not the point. If it was me, probably, I would have gone and called and I said, you know, I'm concerned, what is this? What SR2 and B1 means? I'm not aware. But we're here today, and I'm just feel for you, but at the same time, you know, like the mayor said, let's keep the meeting going on.
Okay, so we need to vote on this motion. We need to vote on the motion to table the item. We have a motion and a second. All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? All right. Motion carries. So.
I'm sorry. Everybody's talked, and I just want to say we were not saying that you weren't doing things according to the law or that you were doing things differently or you're trying to do something under the
not
table.
Not at all.
We did not want to make that impression.
And
we were not accusing anybody of anything. It's just that in this case, there were factors that needed to be considered, we felt, needed to be considered. And we did have people that did go to the meeting, and we still didn't get anywhere with that. So I just want to make it really clear that we weren't accusing anybody of doing anything shady or under the table or not doing it
not
right or anything like that. It's just there were things that needed to be known that, and like the end result may still be the same, but it needed to be a different way, and I'm sorry I'm out of order. I apologize.
Well, Alderman, have anything further to say? Okay, with that being said, I'm going to close the public improvement.
I think we still need to consider
the second one. I thought we were going to do it as a pack. Okay, that's fine.
Yeah. All right, so the consideration of the ordinance amending the zoning from B1 to SR2. This scenario from 1515 to 1527. Any consideration, discussion on that?
This one so that somebody can build back on their family place, right? Mm-hmm.
Essentially, this is addressing the scenario that we are where we are taking something to residential to.
Is this spot zoning?
It can next to a larger residential area, so, you know.
Thank you.
Sure. Do we have a permit? All right, we have a motion, is there a second?
Second.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay.
I'm not sure if it's public speech, whatever, but this weekend, one of my neighbors came and told me the tree, yeah,